And the angel said to them, "Be not afraid, for behold, I bring you good news of a great joy, which will come to all the people. For to you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord." Mama nke di nwe no were gwa ha se ojo atula unu ni ne wetere mu unu ozioma nke ongo nke ga dere madu nile ni ni ubochi ta nobodo nke David amutaru unu onye nzoputa Onye bu Kristi jinwenu. Otito derejeso. And happy Christmas to all of you. Because today I bring you good news. News of great joy. For today in the city of David is born for you a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. This is Christmas. I have a Christmas. Ijumu mweka. Ganabo Christmas. Eja zagi hedi chiche. Manangbi kwa ga hetelegu. Ufu inime heja zaga. Nobu birthday Jesu. Abo boshane me birthday Jesu. Each time you ask children, they will tell you all sorts of things. What is Christmas? Some will say it is the time we wear our new clothes. But most of them will remember it is the birthday, the day we celebrate the birthday of Jesus Christ. Of course, children are very keen at celebrating birthdays. And very often we forget. Anechez we hear Christmas. And a Christmas gab mangbaji me every other day akwadi yelile. Bero so so I kwadu makunyo biya bijeri Christmas. This has become the most commercialized feast throughout the world almost in the year. And very often, people don't even remember it is about Jesus Christ. The word Christmas itself, Christ's Mass, the Mass of Jesus Christ. It is about the Mass we celebrate as birthday feast of Jesus Christ. So, Unubunda biara mass this time, today, and Andaja Biechi and this season, they are part of those who really realize that primarily Christmas is about Jesus Christ. If you see many greetings today, this season, this period, you'll find season's greetings. Compliments of the season. What season? We're in the organ matuegu, ipoya Christmas. They just say it's just a holiday, the time of the year when we rest. Now bear in mind, one day and another, they are the same. From the point of view of the number of hours and other things. It is because of the importance we attach to a day that is what makes a day different. Ihu boshia tata. Nemboshi dozo bariyo kukuruji diche. Uno nguru ino ni titi. Ụfọdụ eshimetene Christmas kiri Xmas. E were X kagbo Jesu, kagbo Christ, a half mass. Of course, originally, that X was the first word in the Greek word for Christ, Christos. And some, if you look at our baptismal font, you will see the two, X and Rho, Christos, the two letters. But some think, Kaima ka Jesu bad, Merie ka nyoi jigde. Unwerendo, unkwado he kwadoro Christmas, ahonwa, bondo he waburu, undo he zroshi, undo he guruwayo, undo he kidnapro. Some people planned Christmas this year by the evil they did to others. Some cheated others. There was masism. So that their Christmas, their own Christmas, will be good. Others planned even terrorist attacks to celebrate Christmas, to mark Christmas. Others plan kidnappings. And some plot stealing public fund. Of course, there are also so many good things going on Christmas period, like social activities, fundraising for social projects. Ibia nobodo di chiche nekabai, nobogi Christmas beje me launching. Ejaro loka, ejaro luogo, ejaro lekukwo, ejaro town hall. Very beautiful things. But at the center of this, don't be afraid. Because I bring you a wonderful piece of news. Today you have to celebrate because your Savior is born. And if you pay attention to the celebration and through the readings, you find out that the feast we celebrate today, as I always like to remind you, points to Easter, the feast of light, the feast of love, the feast of sacrifice. The opening prayer thanks God for the gift of this wonderful night in which we celebrate the splendid light, light of the world. I na rio chuku kanyi bonda matari ihe anuwa. We nweki suri ya bu ihe. We batana leze. This is cause for joy and cause for celebration. But it is good also that we know when we celebrate Christmas in all beauty and splendor, we keep our environments clean, beautiful. Some make efforts to pack into their new houses or renovated houses at Christmas. Wonderful. Most parents make an effort to give their children new clothes at Christmas. Wonderful. And above all, we try to exchange gifts. But let us remember that Christmas, the original context of the birth of Christ, was not that easy and that beautiful. First of all, the prophet Isaiah in the first reading tells his people, those who lived in darkness, walked in the land and valley of shadows and misery and suffering, a light will shine. Those who have been suffering because of our exile, because of the war, because of the lack of good direction and governance, a light has come. Because some child is born who will lead his people, advise them, counselor, and bring them to peace, Prince of Peace. But this announcement was made in the midst of suffering. Oza Isaiah Niz, Ndenke Chuku. Bumbo bodi umu Israel no na nukute nsebu. Yititere nka ino na yaketa. The world is walking in darkness and misery. The world is walking in darkness because so many factors and forces keep pushing away and further away that light that comes from God that directs human pilgrimage on earth. But as I said at the beginning of Mass, every year that we celebrate Christmas shows that God is not yet tired of us. He has not given up on us. And because of that, he comes to us when we least expect him and in a context we do not expect. In the midst of our misery and suffering, even when others try to create problems for us, God uses that occasion to bring light into our lives. Ọmụmụ amụrụ Jesu. Ọ bụgụ ga Mary na Joseph ji plan ya bogar. They were not expecting, Mary and Joseph were not expecting this decree of Caesar Augustus. They were living in Nazareth. And Mary was due. And suddenly, this emperor in Rome gave an order that everybody must be counted. What was he doing with census at that time? Control. Control. Taxes. To show he was in charge. To show he could do with the people whatever he wanted. He needed to be sure how many they were. And told everybody to go home to his village to be counted. Maybe because the Jews that time were doing like Nigerians today. If you don't give that type of rule, some will be counted in Nsukka. And they travel to Enugu and they'll be counted again. And they travel to Lagos, they'll be counted again. Or somebody will be counted in Lagos. And when you ask his father in Nsukka, he will tell you his children are 8. Meanwhile, 8 of them have been counted. 1 in Lagos, 1 in Kano, 1 in Port Harcourt. And so on and so forth. So everybody must go home. This changed the plan of a couple expecting their first child. Mutadaga, Kekadaga, Okadadaga. And they were not rich enough to afford the donkey. But they embarked on that journey. Joseph, a patient man. We just concluded the year of St. Joseph. And I repeat, had occasion to remind you regularly during that feast, that year, that Joseph was a model of patience and suffering for others. Yan and Mary. Rute Bethlehem. Of course, they had no house. They had no house in Bethlehem. So they had to look for where to stay, and there was no place to stay. Some will think that there was no place because they didn't want them inside the hotel because they were poor. No, their accommodation is Jume. You know, I work business also many people in the men and sick except their hotel, Nizala. and a hotel lanar mbagan game conference, mbagan game workshop. The only hope, Ijumahe Narna Hotel again, asigno makajam bana screening, or to the Jesu. But that time ne space and giz. So they couldn't find a place. But all that was God's desire in the first place. Neither Augustus, nor Quirinius, nor Joseph, nor Mary knew that by that decree they were fulfilling the prophecy of Micah, who said that the Messiah would be born in Bethlehem. For those who think that many things, the things happening in their life are accidents, things that happen in our lives may not have been planned by us or may not happen as we planned it, and they may even be happening because other people have evil plans or other plans for us. But in the final analysis, as Paul tells us in his letter to the Romans chapter 8, those who love God and those whom God loves, everything will work together and cooperate unto what? Their good. Ihe ọbụla na-eme na ndụ gị, ị ga na-ajụ onwe gị, kedu ihe Chukwu chọrọ iji ihe a mee m, iji ihe a kụziere m? Iri agbụrụ nọ na-atụ gị n'ọnụ, jụmụ onwe gị ese. Ọ ji enweriri ofu ihe bụ ihe ezi Chukwu chọrọ isi na ya mee gị. No hardship or evil comes to you just entirely to destroy. There may be something positive that you are not able to see. And why was she born in a stable? Ebe a na-atọ n'ụmụ anụmanụ nri. In a feeding box, feeding station for animals. Agwa ma munu na nke a mụ chigburu bishop, gam chemer bishop. No nwere bọshị m jere ụlọ. Then name Muslim, no we requiring do can equip my head, Daria, and other go correct. Let me say, Mama, go and ask me, Peru can equip, other go correct. Megabon yoka, Egbelemon oka. See, I get a peru mokan equip, got to go correct. Bossum no before me mean kang or in kato. Go get re monga, amoputaranwa jesu, ni muchichi. Na Bethlehem, no nano bobefa, no nana bugubehe no bumbehe hurube. I am saying, Mama, need the correct. No, I'm not changing, you me, no bugumudir. Otito de Jesu. That was where they found space.
Amolo Jesu eze anye. Na Bethlehem, no, 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 Maria, bobe, aqua, weni, bea, no, 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 choir, glory.
He was put in a place from where animals are fed. That place he was born was not the best arrangement, but that was where he was born. He came in such a simplicity and humility that not even the circumstances, very dirty. Not clean. But that place, and two things we have to bear in mind. One, just like he was born in such not perfect circumstances, so also your life does not need to be perfect before Christ is born in you. Your life does not need to be in order before his miracle takes place in you. Before his transformation, no life is so disordered or so dirty or so unfit that Christ will not enter and transform. It is not about perfection. It is about availability. That stable, that manger, that place where animals are kept have become forever a symbol of the place of the beginning of a new history of humanity. Never you ever lose hope. This our country is dirtier than a stable. Nigeria today is dirtier than the place where Jesus was born. Scattered, shattered, destroyed by greedy men and women who are using political affiliations and religious and ethnic interests to pursue their personal agenda. And people are going to die for them, thinking that they are interested in our common good. We are in a country where almost everybody has become selfish because we need to survive. We no longer know which part of this country is still under the federal government of Nigeria, because every day we lose bits of the country to terrorists. And not even in your own kitchen are you safe. Anywhere in the country. Hardship. Many of you, we are not paid your salaries this month. If you received last month, you were lucky. Iho man make a salary. What can it buy? And yet you don't receive it. And some people are in charge. Violence. Hatred. People open their mouth and anything that comes out of the mouth is hatred and curse. And we are all afraid. But even in these circumstances, in this valley of darkness, with this shadow surrounding us, Isaiah tells us the light has shone because a Savior is born. Yes. That Savior is born in your heart. Your heart may not be clean, but make it available. Your marriage does not need to be perfect. Your family does not need to be perfect. You may have had a disordered life in the past, but it can rebuild. If the world had been perfect, he would not have needed to come. For sinners and to call them to repentance. That is why this feast we celebrate is about Jesus Christ, and it is a feast of love. No matter what people do, yes, commerce, business, social activities, Love and the sentiment of love always remains. In our way, a greeting, sir, in the send. It is all about Christ, and it is all about love. For God so loved the world that he sent his only Son, so that he will repay and reconstruct and reorder a disordered system. And how? By being counselor and light. I keep saying it. The last hope for survival as for Nigeria. The last hope for survival for Nigeria, whether as a group or as parts, is the gospel of Christ. The love that gospel brings. That is our last hope. If we don't allow Christ and his teaching and his principle of love and sacrifice to rebuild our country and also our world, there is no more hope. So that is why this feast is also a feast of our nation. Hope for our nation. The feast of love. And he was put in a manger because he came to feed the world, to nourish the world. To nourish us, especially from the altar of the Eucharist through the sacrifice on the cross. Even at his birth, he was already telling us how he would save through sacrifice, through love, and through acceptance of the excluded and conditions that seem terrible and irreparable. That is why we are happy and we are rejoicing that today is Christmas. Hope is not lost. Hope card. I hope I had an agabaza. Gajesu jinorni mani. How much we allow Christ that is born in our disordered lives, in our dirty hearts, in our sinful lives, if we allow him to put our lives in order, advising us through his presence, then through us. We bring the message to others, the message of joy. Do not be afraid. For today, I bring you good news. For today is born for you in the city of David, a Savior who is Christ the Lord. Egwatunulu, makane wetrimunu ozioma, tata, naburu David, nobodo David, amuputaru no nyenzopota, bo Christi, dingwenu. Happy Christmas!